I want to show you an AI writer that's gonna be your sidekick all the way. Basically, your co-pilot with AI writing. It's gonna be along with you if you are searching around on Google, if you are on social media, and you wanna write some posts, HixsAI is gonna be there. If you're gonna write content on Google Docs, if you're gonna use their own platform to write content, basically, it's gonna be your co-pilot the whole way. So it's pretty cool, and it's gonna be really interesting showing you this tool because basically, it's gonna save you a lot of time and it's really handy to use. So let me show you HixsAI right now. What's up, SaaS Masters? My name is George, and today I'm gonna show you HixsAI. Like I mentioned before, it's gonna be your co-pilot for AI writing. Basically, it's gonna be available everywhere where you are searching and, well, browsing. So let me show you. Basically, the first thing I would recommend with HixsAI, if you plan to jump on it, is install the Chrome extension because it's gonna work on social media, it's gonna work on Google Docs, and it's gonna work practically anywhere with a little command //. So it's pretty cool. So let me show you. Let me jump over to my main dashboard to show you first. They have a bunch of tools that are going to help you with AI writing. Now, one of the things that I've noticed with HixsAI, aside from other type of AI writers, is that they focus a lot on user experience. The Chrome extension is fantastic. Their panel is fantastic. And the tools that they pre-built for AI generation is also fantastic. Now I'm gonna go through all of these to show you what you're gonna get, but let me get started with the Chrome extension because I think it's really handy. So if you're on Gmail, if you're on social media, you're gonna be able to use HixsAI. Now let me jump into my Facebook right here. And this is my Facebook group. Now you're gonna see that there's this little handy Chrome extension that pops up here, which is HixsAI. I can go ahead and move this if I like, and I have some options to move it to the left if I like. Now, if I click on it, it's gonna open up a panel where I can start using the AI writing capabilities. Now, in this case, I have the option for chat or for writing. Now, right off the bat, I'm able to use the tools for AI writing by typing messages here. So this is way quicker than jumping into ChatGPT. Plus, it has more additional tools than ChatGPT has. It gives you ideas of what you need to ask next, so that makes it much better to use. Now, in this case, I'm gonna use something like this that they provide as an example, and I'm gonna hit enter for this, and it's gonna ask me, can you provide me with a brief description of your Germany trip? Let me type something really, basic for this, and I'll say train rides are really long, but have great views. Okay, so let me, but I guess it understood it's trains, right? Here we go, and it's gonna write for me. There we go. And I got content here that I can use. I go ahead and copy this and use it on social media. Now, like I mentioned, this is gonna work alongside with you the whole way. So on social media, let's just say I'm here, I wanna write a post, I'll click on this one, and basically, boom, I got here HixsAI also. So if I disable this right here, I still have it in social media and Gmail, etc., and I can use it there. So if I click on it, it's ready to go so I can start writing and ask something for it. Plus I have the tone that I can select. So I can say, let me ask something. Write a post, precious metals in the world. Okay, that's written wrong. Precious metals in the world. Write a short post. Here we go. I'm gonna set the tone to something else. Let's use sympathetic, no, encouraging. So let's go ahead and generate this. And here we go, we got a post. Well, that's a super long post. All right, so we got this long post right here. Again, we can make it shorter, we can highlight this and use HixsAI to do something with it. In this case, I'll leave it as it is for now. Now, another way that we can generate content is by obviously selecting here. If I don't click on these icons and I just wanna get AI right away, I can hit // and boom, I got it activated. And again, I can go ahead and use it right from here. And I have the option to use 3.5 or 4.0, depending on the plan that you are on. So it's super easy. Now that // comes in really handy, especially when you don't have these icons available. For example, Facebook, Twitter, and all those, you got it available really easily and handy. But if you don't, you just hit //. Same thing goes with Google Docs. So in Google Docs right here, if I'm just writing something, I hit // 2 times, boom, I activate HixsAI. So it makes it really handy. So if I need to write a continuous writing, if I need to brainstorm ideas, blog posts, etc., all of this, I can use it from right here really easily. Now, let me go ahead and clear this out. Okay, here we go. And again, I have the option to highlight something that's written or just hit //, and I'll say brainstorm ideas on I'll say top 10 countries to visit that are inexpensive. Okay, let's go ahead and see what it writes. And it's going to write me the top 10 countries that it knows that are inexpensive to travel and write. So basically, it's writing the content for me really easily. I can go ahead and say done and it'll insert it. I can continue writing. So if I need to ask it something else, make it more complex, I can make it shorter, longer, try again, or discard. In this case, I'll say done. I can go ahead and continue and write, for example, continue writing about this. And it knows now it's going 11, 12, 13, 14, et cetera, because it's taking into consideration the content that I have already. Now that's based on writing more content. I'm gonna discard that. But what happens if I highlight something like this? Well, if I highlight it, I also get options. I can ask AI based on what I've highlighted. I can rewrite this. I can go ahead and summarize it. I can translate it, and I have more options available here. Now you can see that there's a little pin here. That's because it's going to pin what I use the most. And in this case, I'm going to say I want make shorter and make longer to be available right away because that's what I use the most and I want to make it longer. So here we go. It's writing this, making it longer about this hungry country. Hungary. Yeah, that's at least how you say it, not hungry. And I can replace the section, insert below, continue writing, etc. I'm going to insert this below and it wrote about this. So obviously I'll need to make this look better, but I got the content that I need. So it's super easy and handy to use. Now there's the AI mode, there's the power mode, and there's the chat mode. So it depends what you want to use. I think HixsAI has a bunch of tools that we can use alongside. Like I said, it's going to be your copilot. Once you start using it, you're going to love it and start using the best tools that fit your needs. Now that's for the Chrome extension. Now, just to finish up with Chrome extension, like I said, it works in several places. There's options for a Chrome extension. If I go to my main panel and if I go to account settings or from the Chrome extension, I'll go to extension settings. And in the settings, I'm gonna set my settings for all of this. For example, do I wanna always display this one? I can go ahead and set it to off if I don't need it. Like I said, you have the command, and if you're on social media, you'll have that little icon pop up. You can set it to the left or right, and you can just drag this if it's on the way or in the way of something. The shortcut for this, Command P or Control P if you're on Windows. The quick lookup if you want to have that enabled or not. If you want to display it in certain social media accounts, you can go ahead and set this on or off. So if you're not planning to use it in certain social media accounts, just go ahead and turn it off. Display extensions for Google Docs. So yes, I want to use it there. Display placeholder if I want to enable that also, go ahead and do so. But if in this case, if it's too overwhelming, or if it's just on the way of everything, you can just go ahead and turn it off. Search engine options. Oh, that's a cool one. So for example, if I search on Google for something, HixsAI is gonna help me too. So if I go here and I'm gonna search for something like, I'll just search for that. What a Teflon, cruise lines, and here we go. And it's not in the way of the content. So HixsAI also responded here. So that saves me time. So I have the information from Google, and I also have it from HixsAI. I can continue in chat for this. Let me go ahead and clear this, and I can continue with this information. So I can ask it something else. I can go ahead and continue writing from this. And it's pretty easy. It's pretty cool that it works alongside with me in the search engines. Okay. You set up email preferences. So again, this works also on Gmail. You got your icon and you have your settings here if you plan to use it or not there. So that's for the Chrome extension. Okay, there's way more to talk about it, but in this case, I think you got the idea that it's really robust and it's gonna help you alongside. Now, once we're in the platform, there's a lot to cover. There's a lot of popular tools that we can use. First of all, you got your analytics on the top of your usage. You got your account usage here, depending on the plan that you are on. The most popular tools, or we can go ahead and view them all. And when we view them all, we can start favorite, what we want to have available at like your top usage. Okay, so maybe some of these would be your top users. So you'll favorite these to have them available really easily. Now, if you want to use any of these, like, I don't know, content improver, content summary, content improver, let's use that one. And I'm going to grab a piece of content that I have here. I'll grab this. I'll leave the one aside there. Let's go back. And I'm going to add this as my content. It's about the Tower of London and how it's important, etc. So how do we want it to improve, be innovative, or be similar to initial content? So if you want to be, I don't know, if you want to keep it tight and you don't want to want it to go a little bit loose, go ahead and use similar to initial content or be innovative to give me more ideas. Target audience, everyone, shoppers. I'm gonna say pre-owners. I'll say everyone for this one, for this case. Tone of voice, I'll use childish. I wanna make this fun. Language, it's English. And I'm gonna use GPT-4 for this one. So I wanted to generate two outputs and I'm gonna generate it. And let's wait and see what it's gonna generate for us. Okay, here we go. We got two outputs right here. And like you saw, I selected childish. So we're gonna get a fun piece of content here. So go ahead and pause this and read it for yourself. Now, we don't have to actually use one of these. I can go ahead and use another one. I can go ahead and select a professional one, just in case and see I want what type of output I'm gonna get. So let's wait for that output also. Okay, so now we got the two other pieces of content. I got two childish ones and two professional ones. Now, if I click on details, it's gonna tell me what I use. So in this case, I use this one to improve and I use childish and two outputs. And for the other one, this is what I use, more professional tone. And I'm able to check these out. If I'm gonna use them, I can go ahead and edit these if I like. So if I don't like something, I can go ahead and select this. And of course, I got my handy Chrome extension if I wanna use it for HixAI and improve it or fix it. So whatever I select, I can go ahead and use it here, okay? Now, I'm gonna cancel this one. I can go ahead and copy this and use it somewhere. Okay, so I got the content that's improved based on what I selected. And just like that, there's a lot of tools that we can use. There's the most popular ones, article and blogs, the ads. You can see how the start ones are first. So please take your time in the beginning to select what you want to have first, because obviously you want to have it handy and use it right away. For social media, for emails, I love for emails, the website copy SEO, for WooCommerce, general writing, and the all. So let me go into email. I'm going to go into this more in depth, but I'm going to use the email writer. So more on that in a bit. So next we have the AI writers, everything that has to do with AI, like I showed you, long form article. I'm not going to go into long form in this video, but it's really robust. You can go into the describe topic and you're going to get practically like a Word type document and go through it. But in this case, I'll make a dedicated video for the long article. More of that in the link once that's out. Next, we have the Hix editor. So Hix editor, also you got your editor here, type Word, and you can start writing content. Again, I can forward slash this right away, and I can write something like, here we go. Let's go ahead and send this off, and boom. Here's the top 5 precious metals in the world. That's what I wanted to know, and here we go. We just got it. These are more rare, but okay, they're precious. So this is for long form and articles. So you can start writing your article right away there. Next, we have the Hicks email writer. Now there's two sections to this, which is compose and reply. So with compose, we're gonna say who it's for. For this, for Mac Steel, the email subject is gonna be here. I say, I need you to pay me right now, okay? And then I'm gonna continue here and I'm gonna say, it's gonna be a customer service, business email, meeting email, reminder email, and it's gonna be about, I need to get paid for the website service, and it's going to be $1,000. Let's hit enter and it's gonna write it for us. So it knows it's Max because obviously I wrote it there. I'm gonna insert it to email, and now we have the professional email right here. You can go ahead and copy this and use it in the email. Now you have a similar tool like this directly on Gmail, but just to show you here, if you're gonna compose it here. Now, if it's gonna be reply, well, this is where you're gonna write it. And for this, I'm gonna actually use this one. And I need a reply for this. So I'm gonna select for reply. And here we go. So now it's gonna give us suggested replies, okay? So prioritize, discuss, or resolve. So I wanna resolve this. These are ideas that are given to me automatically by HixsAI, and it's gonna help me write this. So it's gonna be resolved promptly for mutual benefit. I'll reach out to you shortly. So basically it was evasive in this case, but we can go ahead and rewrite this or change it if we like. So I really like this tool. Next, we have Hix Chat. And in Hix Chat, you have two options. You can use Hix Chat or you can use ChatGPT. In this case, I'll show you Hix Chat. So in Hix Chat, okay, so this is what I wrote right now. Top destinations for traveling with a newborn, something that I have to look forward to with my new baby that was just born. So I need to know these kind of things. And here we go, it's giving me ideas. And boom. Now, something I like about Hix Chat is that it comes along with extra questions that it thinks I might need to know. So the next ones would be, are these destinations suitable for all seasons? What are some tips for traveling with a newborn? So also like this, because that's something I also want to know. And it works along with you. And again, every single time, it's gonna give you ideas to keep writing. Well, asking in this case. So again, based on what I just used and think I might need to ask, this is pretty cool because it helps me with ideas of what I need to know. So instead of me writing the whole thing, it helps me out. And next we have the chat GPT. Then you probably checked that out already. We're gonna skip that for now. And then we have the recent content. And recent content is where we're gonna view all the documents, emails that we've written. We can go back through these and go ahead and use them again if we need or not. But there's a lot of tools that you can go ahead and check out. Several popular tools. I think they have over 120 tools that you can use. And basically, go ahead and try HixsAI out for yourself. See for yourself that it's really handy and that they work alongside with you. It's like your copilot for AI writing. So check it out. Link will be provided in the description. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that little bell notification when you want to get notified when new videos come out. And that's a wrap.